Hey everybody, thanks for being here. This week we're on Lake Almanor in Northern California trolling flies for rainbow trout. Now if you want to learn how to catch more fish, stay tuned. I'm Justin Wolf and this is Angler West Television. This morning we're on Lake Almanor, a Northern California reservoir known for great trout fishing, especially with trolling flies. Today we're with John Crotty and Denis Peirce targeting rainbow trout.
Well, we just launched at the Canyon Dam boat ramp down on the south end of the lake, one of two public ramps here on Lake Almanor. We're going to head over the east shore. There's a bunch of pond smelt over here, so we're going to go see if we can get something going with the pond smelt hatch. We're going to start right here over on off the east shore. We're going to start out in deeper water, work our way in, and start fishing the shallows. We're going to target fish in the 20 to 30 foot depth mark and fish them throughout the water column until we get a pattern going.
Starting with white, which is imitating the bait fish in here, which is pond smelt. Right now the pond smelt are 3 inches, 2.5, 3 inches. So we're picking a fly that's this size. And I'm trying to get the air out of the feathers right off the bat so it starts swimming well to begin with. I've had them, you know, trap air in them and not swim quite as well. So I like to get them pre-wet. And as soon as he gets the thing started, I'm gonna have the first fly in the water. This is Jayfair, is white shad fly, and the flash on this one is copper, but it's all white, which imitates the pond smelt that are in the lake here, and I'm going to be twitching it rather than putting it on an action disc to start with, and I'm going to be starting at the top of the water column with the, you know, 2-3 foot below the surface.
So I have the same thing. We're trying to imitate the pond smelt. The lake is loaded full of pond smelt right now, so we're going to target them with this white fly. We're gonna have two rods on downriggers, and then we're gonna twitch two on the side. So we're gonna try to mix it up, see if we can find a way to get these fish to bite. So we're gonna start out with four rods. We're gonna have two rods on downriggers. We're gonna have one at 15 foot, one at 10 foot, and Denis is gonna twitch one rod on one side of the boat, and I'm gonna twitch one on the other side. Keep those in the top 10 feet of the water column. So. We're just putting our line out right now. All of them have wiggle discs on them. Do you have wiggle discs on yours, Denis?
No,
nope, just the downriggers. We're gonna do the downriggers with wiggle discs. We're gonna set back 80 feet to start. If the lake comes down, we'll go back a little further.
I'm getting through the leader and heading for I got a half a color of lead core on the end of 100 feet of floating fly line. That's where the lead core begins. And with half a color out, it'll run the fly, depending on the speed of the boat, it'll run the fly anywhere from 2 foot to 5 foot below the surface. And with the float, we're backing it up with a floating fly line that will, we got 100 feet of floating fly line on there, and we'll be able to track where the fly is based on where we see the floating line out behind the boat.
Yeah, well, we have some fish down in the bottom. We just went over a big pot of pond smelt bait fish, so they're down on the bottom right now. We haven't been able to really get anything going with that lower bite. These fish are coming up and grabbing pond smelt on the surface, so we're going to target them in the 15-foot of water mark. Now, the water temp 61.2 right now. It'll warm up into the 63-degree mark. We're going to have a nice brisk start to the morning, but the temperatures are going to get up into the 70s today on Almanor, which is unusual for October, this time in October. I'm going to put a hot orange on here, see if that does anything to start with. We have two white flies out. We have a cinnamon, Jayfair cinnamon. Now we're going to go with the hot orange. On a couple of flies, we put the disc right at the fly, but on this rod here, we're going to put it up 10, 12 inches above.
All right, the slide lock bead is basically, it's a bobber stop that's really adjustable, that you can tune the fly by the speed you have of the boat and then the distance that the disc is above the fly. And, you know, get a boat speed that you like and then start adjusting it, and you can get the fly to swim. The disc right on the nose will make the fly puff out and have a bigger profile. The disc up the line will create more of a laminar flow and make more of a long skinny fly profile. So you can tune the fly by moving the disc up and down or by changing the boat speed.
Just go one color, Denis?
Yeah. What that one is designed to do is to fish in tandem with a top line so that when you turn corners, that one the flies are the same depth but different distances back from the boat, and when you turn corners, the lines will cross without tangling.
Right now I'm at 1.7 miles an hour, 1.8. We're going to try that, and we'll adjust our speeds as needed. We're going to go anywhere from a mile and a half to 2.2, 2.3 miles an hour.
Fish on the screen now.
We're seeing fish on the screen. The fish are chasing pond smelt right now, so we're just really looking for pond smelt and find the feeding fish.
It's always important to start early, but the bite, if they're feeding on pond smelt, they'll eat all day long.
Welcome back to Lake Almanor. I'm Justin Wolf. John Crotty and Denis Peirce are targeting rainbows with trolling flies to imitate the lake's abundant bait fish population, so it's important to find the bait.
At the beginning of the year, January, we'll fish down by the dam, and if you look right back behind us, that's the dam for Lake Almanor. And in the wintertime, December, January, February, we'll fish down there when the water temp's in the 40s. And then as the pond smelt migrate out of there, the insect hatches will start here around the April mark when the water temp gets up into the high 50s, low 60s, and the fish will be, the majority of the fish will be on the northwest section of the lake between Prattville and the tip of the peninsula in that 30 to 45, 50 feet of water. And then from there, as the lake warms up into the mid 70s, we'll start targeting fish in the deeper water. The thermocline's down around the 45 foot mark when it's 75 degrees here typically. So we'll slow troll that time of year. So right now these fish are transitioning. We're trying to entice them. The slow boat bite is, while it's still good, it's going to start slowing down.
This is called the Jay Fair Twitch, and it was developed by Jay Fair, this whole line system. It was meant for shallow trolling at the north end of Eagle Lake. And it's a system that puts the fly 2, 3, 4, 5 foot below the surface, depending on how fast the boat's going. But by doing this twitch, which is actually manipulating a floating fly line, it's sort of like mending a fly line, it'll make the fly pull and it'll pause, and it makes the fly puff and work its way through the water. It puts a lot of life in it. And it's my opinion that when it comes to trolling flies, it's the movement of the fly that entices the fish. You know, they're visual feeders to a large extent, and it's that movement of the fly swimming through the water that's the key to the effectiveness of the fly.
So we're seeing lots of pond smelt on our screen right now. The pond smelt out here, typically they'll start their cycle in early June. They'll start to hatch and they'll just get bigger from there. Right now they're 2.5 to 3 inches long, and we have a really big hatch going off this year. They'll be all over on the screen. You'll see them boiling on the surface, and we'll see fish chasing them. And when the fish come up to get them, they'll boil on the surface, and then we'll also see seagulls diving for the pond smelt, the floaters. So as the fish go through a bottom of school of them, they'll knock a few unconscious that float to the top. And so we're just looking for bird activity and surface activity to see if we can get one to hit on these flies.
Little guy?
I think so.
It was a smaller fish. There's a lot bigger ones here in Almanor. And one of the things I'm doing right now is grooming the fly back out, because if you have the wing or the tail wrapped under the hook, the fly doesn't swim properly. It sits off to the side. And it's a good thing every once in a while to check your fly and get it groomed out properly, sort of like that. And then it's going to swim real well later on. The basic assumption out here is white flies matching up with the pond smelt, but we're running a number of different colors trying to see if we can come up with a pattern, because white doesn't automatically work each time. This is the cinnamon brown with the copper flash in it, and it was on a downrigger with a wiggle fin action disc in front of it, and they hit that I guess, 10, 15 foot below the surface, which wasn't what I was expecting to begin with, but it's apparently what the fish wanted. So we'll be running a bunch of different colors today.
Okay, so we got this one right on the surface with that white fly. I think this might be the Tui chub pattern we put on here, Denis. Right on the surface. This feels like it'll be a couple of pounds anyway. You know, we have fish in here up to 6-8 pound rainbows and 10 plus pound browns. And 5 pound fish are not uncommon on an Almanor. These fish are in great shape right now. This is a nice fatty.
You want him in the boat or?
So a nice healthy pond smelt fed rainbow on Lake Almanor. It's about 2.5-3 pounds, I'd say.
We're fishing Lake Almanor in Northern California out of Quail Lodge with John Crotty, our guide and lodge owner, along with Denis Peirce.
So a nice, healthy, pond smelt fed rainbow on Lake Almanor. It's about 2.5-3 pounds, I'd say. So far we've gotten one fish on a cinnamon at 10 feet deep, and we switched over to a Tui chub pattern here without the wiggle disc, and we're just running it right on the surface. So this was right on top. We got a little better grade of fish that last go around, but here is the Tui chub pattern. We are starting to catch a few Tui chubs out here, which is something new, and it's just been over the last few years. So the Tui chub are out here, as well as pond smelt for bait fish.
So you had me go back 80 feet before I set it in the downrigger. Why are you going back 80 if we're going down with a downrigger?
I like getting that bait as far away from the boat as possible. On a day like this morning, we can get by with 80 feet, but quite often we're 100, 125, and if it's flat, calm, we're 150 feet behind the boat.
At what, is there, and, as you go deeper, can you go shorter?
You can. And 80 feet, actually 60 feet is as less of a setback as I'll ever have out there. Normally I like being back 80 feet, even if I'm going down 40 feet on the wire. And like I said, if it's flat and we're in 15 feet of water, I'm 150 feet back and serpentining. That's the main thing. You know, keep the boat, the S pattern, just keep the boat moving. Try not to have your bait directly behind the boat.
Okay. What should I be setting it for right now?
Right now we're going to be at 10 feet there. We've got this one at 15, that one at 10. We've got one fish off that earlier, and one on the surface. So we're still trying to find a pattern. There you go, Denis. Oops, that one went.
There. You want to take?
Go for it.
You want to clear any other ones?
No. Little guy. Another little guy. This might be one of our pen fish from last year. This guy unharmed. You can see the copepods. This guy's got some copepods on him. Oh, there we go. Another one on that cinnamon color, Denis. 10 feet, cinnamon. Still looking for a little better grade of fish with the wiggle disc. When we have these on downriggers, I always have them on the wiggle disc. The Almanor Fishing Association raises and releases 50,000 rainbows in this lake every year, and that fish right there is about the size that they would be right now based upon when we released them in April. We'll be getting this year's pen fish here next week. Another 50,000 rainbows from the Dara Springs Fish Hatchery, and we'll get them next week, and we'll hand feed them throughout the winter and let them go next April when the water temp reaches the 60 degree mark and we have a big insect hatch going off. It's one of the reasons this is such a great fishery. This one feels like it might be a little better grade of fish here.
Would you like me to clear the other lines?
No, we'll be okay. Right. I'm just going to slow down the trolling motor. This is number four. Number four, this one is, once again, right on the surface. We're just twitching it right on the surface.
A few copepods on them.
Yeah, they'll drop off this winter when the water temp drops a little bit. Well, it's not ready. It's a good fish. Net Denis? Yeah, I think so.
I think he's ready. You want to bring him in the boat?
Nope. Not unless you guys want to keep him. There he goes. Second quality fish on the 2E chub pattern, right on the surface.
A great place to stay while fishing Eagle Lake and Lake Almanor is Quail Lodge at Lake Almanor. Plenty of room for boats, comfortable rooms, and easy access to the lakes. Learn more at quaillodgelakealmanor.com. Welcome back to Lake Almanor in Northern California. I'm Justin Wolf. In the shadow of Mount Lassen, we're hooking up with some great rainbows with trolling flies.
This one's the J-Fair 2E chub pattern. The basic construction of all these flies is what Jay called shuck, which is sort of a chenille type of a product that is translucent, the sun shines through it real well, and it dyes a lot of really nice colors. This one is the 2E chub, which is a light olive with copper flash in it, but it's not a bad representation of a bass, the general coloration of it. And when it gets dark or gets wet, it gets a little bit darker, but it's a good imitation of a baby smallmouth or a largemouth bass. So it's just a good all-around pattern. In the fly business, what people say is whatever the color of the bottom is the color of the fly you should use, because most things in the water are camouflage. And this is a good, not a bad imitation of the color that the water is and everything in there right now, which it's a good place to start, and it's been effective today, better than the real gaudy fly that I was trying to run. But what I'd like to try on these is that water-based Pro-Cure stuff. Let's see what that'll do. Used it for the first time the other day, and this is the first one I've seen that didn't mat up and ruin the fly. And this one is that water-based guy. And let's see what it does. Somebody wanted to bite that 2E chub thing again. And I'm glad you talked me into changing out that fly.
Need the net?
Not necessarily. I think we could just pop him loose. He's not going to be a keeper.
Oh, what a beautiful.
Look at how fat that guy is. So he hasn't missed many meals.
2E chub.
This is one that we had put the scent on, and that's the first scent I've had that really didn't mat up, the real fine fly tying materials. I really liked it, and I think I'll be trying that in the future. But what I'm trying to do is groom out the wing. This part here is wrapped underneath, and if you pull everything out the way it's supposed to, the way it was tied originally, it'll track true and swim well. If there's parts wrapped around the shank of it, it'll tend to roll on its side partway rather than track straight up and straight down. So I like to comb, groom them out is what I call it. But let me put a little of that Procure on there and see if that outfishes John.
That's another little guy. Oh, popped him off. 2 week chub.
He's starting to fight pretty well.
Nice rainbow.
I think it's the biggest one I've hooked today. But I had been twitching the rod for an hour, it seemed like, and I got tired of it, put it in the rod holder, and 5 minutes later of just dragging it through the water, the fish bit it. So. But it almost feels that if I just put the wood on them, it would break the line.
Yeah, we're in no danger, no buoys around. That's a good fish, Denis.
It is.
That's a real nice. Look at how fat that guy is.
And is that two-y chub?
Yep.
Again.
That two-y chub pattern seems to be the ticket.
It's on the menu today.
Well, if anybody was into eating fish, this would be the guy.
The thing about Almanor and Crowley and Stampede and all those is they're flooded meadows, and the fertility of the soil under the meadow is what drives the food chain. And most of the trophy trout lakes around are east side or flooded meadows, put it that way. And it's actually cheaper to build a little tiny dam across the canyon and flood a huge meadow if you're, you know, trying to store water. But as far as building a food chain in a lake that produces fish, flooded meadows is it, and Almanor is a prime example of that.
Hey, I hope you enjoyed today's episode. You know, without the support of the sponsors, there would be no show. So please thank them when you can. Now, get out there and do some great fishing.